Welcome to my channel, Investing Untangled. On this channel, I post videos about stock market research, complete and detailed stock and business analysis. And if this is something that interests you, then subscribe to this channel and follow my content here. In this video, we'll take a deep dive into Facebook. In this expensive market of ours, it has become very hard to find companies that are trading at a reasonable valuation. And I think Facebook might be a good investment opportunity because it is a growth company and it is modestly undervalued. And I'll show you why I think so. In this video, I'll cover their business model and how they generate revenues. We'll also check their financials and their recent business performance. Then we'll assess valuations and figure out the intrinsic value of the stock. And finally, we'll look at their management team. So without further ado, let's get to it now.
So we'll start with their business model. Facebook, as we know, is a major social media company, and its platforms, Facebook and Instagram, are used by different companies, smaller companies, bigger companies, for advertising their products, and Facebook charges them a fees, and that's how it generates its revenue. And another part of their business, which is up and coming, it's still kind of in its infancy, is Oculus, where they develop virtual reality products. So right now, their most established revenue stream is actually advertising. So most of their revenues come from advertising right now. Let's look at their financials now. So I have pulled here data from the last 10 years, all the way from 2010. So you can see their revenues have grown pretty strongly, $1.9 billion in 2010, and currently it's close to $80 billion. Earnings have also shown a very strong growth, $606 million to right now $25 billion. Book value per share has grown more than 8 to 9 times, from almost $5 to $41 right now. And cash flows have also shown a very strong growth, from $698 million to $33 billion, and free cash flow from $405 million to almost $20 billion, $19 billion. In 2020. So all these numbers show that Facebook has had a very strong growth in all these years. Okay, looking at their profitability now, they have very good profit margins, very high profit margins. And we know that it's a tech company, and tech companies generally tend to have higher profit margins because their capital expenditure is lower. And you can see here, it has consistently been very high. I generally like companies that have profit margins in excess of 12%. Looking at returns, what kind of job their management team has done, returns on equity and return on invested capital, both of these numbers are actually looking pretty good. I like companies with returns of over 15% a year. And you can see here, these numbers look really good. Okay, now we'll check their financial condition, their financial health. So looking at their debt levels now, and here you can see debt to equity is very, very low. You can see they have maintained a very strong balance sheet throughout. They have very, very low debt. And their current ratio, meaning how well can they cover their current liabilities, you can see this ratio is very high. I like companies where the ratio is about 1.5, and Facebook is extremely high on this side. And another thing that I'll show you here, what percentage of sales ends up as their free cash flow. Here you can see, as of now, they have almost 25% of their sales ending up as free cash flow in the business, which is extremely good. And this has been actually pretty stable in this range, sometimes even much higher. So all these numbers show that Facebook is a very strong cash generating machine. Okay, next up, we'll look at what has been the impact on their business of this current economic turmoil that we are living in right now. So this is from the earnings report from the most recent quarter. It's the third quarter of 2020. And you can see that their revenues have actually increased compared to the third quarter of 2019. And the whole 9 months, there has been an increase in revenues. And their net income has also gone up. So these numbers show basically that their business actually did not get impacted, and they have continued their growth. And we know that actually a lot of companies pulled their advertisements from Facebook around the second or third quarter of last year because of the social unrest that was going on. But even then, that actually did not impact their numbers at all, and they have actually continued their growth performance in spite of losing business there. Now, whenever we're looking at a company, we have to understand its competitive advantage, if it has some kind of an economic moat. I apologize for the low quality of the graph. This is straight from their 10Q. But what you can see is that their daily active users has actually been steadily going up quarter after quarter. So this is different quarters. This is in billions. So this is 1.8 billion people who are using their platforms daily, which is a huge, huge number. So these are daily active users. Now looking at monthly active users, and here you also see that there has been a steady rise, and this is worldwide. The other number was also worldwide. So all over the world, there has been actually a steady rise in active users of Facebook. And right now, monthly active users stand at close to 2.8 billion people. The population of the world is 7.8 billion people, and 2.8 billion of those use Facebook on a monthly basis, which I think is a huge, huge number. And competing with a company that operates at this scale, that has a consumer and customer base of this level, is very hard. So this gives Facebook a very strong competitive advantage, and it's not easy to compete with a company like this. So all these parameters are checked. Our business is growing. It has grown throughout in the last 5, 6, 8 years. It has a strong competitive advantage. It has very low levels of debt. Now we want to check how they are being innovative to extend their business further. So here you can see Facebook is not only focused on their social media revenues, but they are also extending and expanding their investments across the world. So here, for example, Facebook invested almost $6 billion in this company called Jio. Jio Platforms Limited is a subsidiary of Reliance Industries Limited in India. And Reliance Group is a massive conglomerate company in India, and Jio is their telecommunication platform, which has been massively successful in this country. And here you see Facebook is actually betting pretty big by investing almost $6 billion in Jio. And in my opinion, that's actually very smart, because India is an emerging market and middle class there is rising very quickly. That means more and more people are actually getting internet and are connected with the world now through telecommunications, and Facebook wants to actually benefit from this opportunity. Another thing that they recently did was they actually partnered with Shopify, and they're setting up these online shops with Shopify, and Shopify is actually using their huge customer and consumer base that they have. And here you can see Shopify announced a partnership with Facebook to help businesses create Facebook shops, a new and free tool helping merchants create a customized online storefront for Facebook and Instagram. And what this does is that there are so many people who are using Facebook and Instagram, and they actually get an opportunity, and merchants who are setting up their online shop can actually reach this huge market online. So these are great indicators of great businesses when they are not only extending their revenues in the things that they are focused on, but they're innovating in different directions and investing in other companies and growing with them. And this is how they are basically still focused on growth and are trying to find growth opportunities. Now we'll look at valuations, if Facebook is at a right price right now. So going to Yahoo Finance and going to statistics here, I'll check out some valuation metrics here. And you can see they're trading at a forward PE of 24. The market S&P 500 index is trading at a PE of around 35. And this is a strong growth company, which is trading at a forward PE of 24, which I think is pretty undervalued relative to the market. Another indicator of being undervalued is the PEG ratio. Whenever it is below 1, that indicates that the company's projected earnings growth is actually higher than the price at which it's trading right now. So this also shows that Facebook is currently undervalued. Now, if we look at valuation on Simply Wall Street, and here also actually analysts think that the fair price of Facebook is around $318, and it currently trades at a price of $256 as of recording this video. And the analysts here think that it is almost 20% undervalued. Now, if you look at the future growth estimates of this business, analysts still think that this business is going to grow with a future growth of 15%. And I plugged this number in and figured its intrinsic value using the discounted cash flow calculator. And I actually wanted to be a little bit more conservative. You should always be more conservative with these future estimations. And I reduced the growth rate to 12 instead of 15. So I got an intrinsic value of $275 at a 10% annual discount rate. So suggesting that it is modestly undervalued. So I do not think that Facebook is heavily undervalued, but I think it's modestly undervalued. And given the growth that it has ahead of it and how the company is innovating and partnering with other companies to grow further, and how their virtual reality products are also shaping up further, and the economic moat that this company has, I think the rewards here actually kind of outweigh the risks. So that's why I feel a little bit more comfortable with this pricing here. And let's look at another thing now. I compared here two companies, Facebook and Twitter. So Twitter, we also know it's a social media giant and also makes money through advertising. And these companies actually went public around the same time. So 2012, 2013, Facebook went public a little bit earlier. But since then, you can see Facebook's shareholder equity book value has grown pretty significantly, suggesting a substantial rise in their business, while Twitter has not really done much. If you look at other parameters like revenue, here also it follows the same trajectory. Facebook has had an exponential rise while Twitter has kind of flatlined. If you look at net income, there also you see the same trend. Facebook stands at $25 billion while Twitter is actually negative. So this suggests how strong this company is and how strongly it has grown as a business and what kind of a competitive advantage it has relative to its competitors. And finally, looking at their executive team, I think they have two of the best executives that are running this team, Mark Zuckerberg and Sheryl Sandberg. I always like companies that are still being led by founders, and this is exactly the case with Facebook. Mark Zuckerberg has actually done a phenomenal job at getting this company to where it is right now, and Sheryl Sandberg is an exceptionally good COO for this company. If you look at her profile, you'll see that she actually has immense experience in this field. She was working as the vice president of global online sales and operations at Google. She has actually a lot of experience and she has done a phenomenal job in the growth of this company. So I think Mark and Sheryl make actually a great team in running this business. And I still think that this business has a lot of growth potential going forward. And this might actually be a good opportunity given how high the market is priced right now. This actually is, in my opinion, a good opportunity to look at Facebook as a potential investment.
And finally, let's look at dataroma.com, which actually compiles the investments of very high-class super investors in the world. And these are all the people that it tracks. And based on their 13F filings, it actually checks what they have invested in, what they've bought in the last quarter, etc. And here you'll see Facebook actually ranks number one. So the top 10 most owned stocks by these superstar investors, Facebook is actually rank one. And if you click on Facebook, you'll see so there is an ownership count of 30, meaning 30 super investors have been interested in Facebook. For example, Li Lu, who is a world famous investor and is known to manage money for Charlie Munger. He bought in Facebook and he actually added 118% more in the third quarter of 2020. And here, if you look at this reported price, which says 261, and if you look at what that means, so this says reported price is the price of the security as of the portfolio date. The value is significant in that it indicates the portfolio manager's confidence in the stock at that price and suggests at least some level of undervaluation or margin of safety. So this gives me actually a lot of confidence that big superstar investors like Li Lu and others also think that at these prices, Facebook has some kind of undervaluation to it. And this has gotten me further interested in Facebook at these prices.
So this finishes up the analysis of the Facebook stock. I own this company and I have picked up actually some more shares in this recent dip. And I think this is a great business model and they have a very strong competitive advantage. So going forward, they still have enough growth that will push the stock price higher. And Warren Buffett has taught us to buy a great company at a fair price rather than buying a fair company at a great price. And that's exactly the situation right here. So I'm very interested in Facebook at these prices. Let me know what you think. Let me know in the comment section below if you are interested in Facebook and if you are buying this stock. If this video was informative for you, please consider leaving a like and subscribe to my channel, Investing Untangled. That'll help my channel a lot. So in the future, I'll be posting more videos about stocks that I'm buying and complete and detailed stock analysis. So please stay tuned and I'll see you in my next video.